good. You got a great audience.
Yeah, aren't they happy?
You always have good audiences here.
It's because we give them a little cupcake before the show.
Oh, is that what it is?
It gets them going, that sugar rush.
You know, you mentioned Bob Barker earlier. You know, I taught him karate for 8 years.
No way.
Yeah, Bob was one of my students during my karate days.
Is he a black belt?
He could have been. He was ready to test for black, but he never had the guts to go up and test. So.
Is he a brown belt? Really,
yeah, he's a brown belt.
Isn't that funny to imagine Bob Barker karate chopping somebody?
Well, he did a movie called Happy Gilmore, and I ran into him in Los Angeles about 2 weeks ago. He said, "Did you see the movie Happy Gilmore?" And I said, "No, I didn't." He said, "Well, man, I was using all that karate, you know, all that stuff on the show."
Really?
He did his karate on Happy Gilmore.
Wouldn't it be funny if he had a really rowdy contestant on The Price is Right? And, like, they started going nuts, and he went, "Oh, you know?"
I think he's had some pretty rowdy ones on there.
You teach karate for a long time,
right?
I
taught for 15 years. Yeah, I was the world champion from 68 to 74.
Wow. And did you like the movie The Karate Kid?
Yes, I did, actually. Yeah.
Any of that stuff accurate? Wax on, wax off?
Well, actually, it was my black belt was the fight choreographer. Really? Pat Johnson was the one that did all that. He's the one that, No, I don't do that. I don't wax my car anyway.
No, you don't have to paint a whole fence up and down.
No, I don't paint a fence either. No.
I hear that Steve McQueen was your student, though, too,
yes,
right?
Yes, Steve was one of my students. He's the one that actually got me into the film business.
No kidding.
Yeah, when I retired as the world champion, he said, "Well, what are you going to do now?" And I said, "I don't know, just probably teach." And he said, "Well, have you ever thought about doing movies?" I go, "Steve, I've never done a high school play." But anyway, he kind of encouraged me to pursue it, and luckily I did.
Was he a good karate student, too?
Oh, yeah, he was tough.
Yeah?
He was a real tough guy, yeah. When he first started, you know, we started working out, and about 2 months in the training, he's just starting to learn his kicks and his punches. He says, "I want to fight." I said, "Steve, you haven't really learned your techniques that well yet."
Right.
And he said, "I want to spar with you." I said, "All right, if you want to spar." So we get up there, and I send him flying across the room with a kick, you know. But I tell you, he gets back up, and he says, "That was good, that's good." And, you know, and he kept right on fighting, and I kept beating the daylights out of him. But I tell you, he got better and better, though.
Have you ever watched this thing that they have on pay-per-view, Ultimate Fighting, where they get to, like, that's really dangerous, isn't it?
Yeah, it's they really go for it. Yeah, in fact, when they first started that, they wanted me to be one of the hosts. I said, "No, I said, someone's going to get killed."
Yeah, really?
Thing, and I don't want to be part of something like that.
Because the guy who usually wins is a karate guy, a kickboxer, black belt.
Yeah, well, the jiu-jitsu are the ones that are really kind of dominating because it's a lot of grappling. And the jiu-jitsu guys, in fact, I train with them.
Really?
Yeah, the Machados, it's a group from Brazil who came over here about, I went to Brazil on a scuba diving vacation, and I was in Rio, and I was going and working out with the different martial arts schools in Rio, and I kept hearing about this jiu-jitsu family. And I thought, geez, I might track them down. So I did, and I went and worked out with them, and I'd done jiu-jitsu for years and all that, and I got on the mat with them, and phew, I was like a beginner.
Really?
And so I brought him to the States, and so I've been training with him for about 10 years. Yeah, but
they kicked your butt?
Yeah, on the mat. They did a number on me on the mat.
You got your butt kicked, Chuck?
I'm afraid I did.
I am surprised.
Yeah, I'll tell you, these guys are tough.
What about the other sort of tough guy, movie karate guys like Jean-Claude Van Damme and Steven Seagal? Who could beat up who?
That is probably the most common question to ask of me.
It is?
I
got to come up with better questions.
Well, the thing is, it's hard to say. You know, Jean-Claude, when he first came over from Belgium, he trained with me for a year and a half. But the thing is that I fought. I was a professional fighter for about 12 years. And so I know what it's like to be in the arena and facing off.
They're just actors.
Well, no, they're martial artists, too.
Oh, they are?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Could you beat him?
I'm not going to answer that.
No, I mean, just between you and me. Huh? I won't tell anyone. Just between you and me.
I'd kick their butt.
Oh, really? He said that he thought they would probably win. More with Chuck Norris after this, including his honeymoon without a wedding.
Yeah, I never knew it'd be this hard.
Yeah. Back with Chuck Norris, who just returned from his honeymoon, but he didn't get married. Explain that, mister.
Has anyone ever tried to have a big wedding? It is a nightmare. Yeah.
One person went to you.
I tell you, I never realized how complicated, you know, because we thought we'd have all of our family and friends come to the wedding. I didn't realize how many friends and family I had until we started putting this together.
Right.
And so I went from 100 to 150, 200, 250. And where we're going to have it, they said, "Look, 280 is maximum. We cannot have another person be able to fit in there." It went up to 280, then 300, and 320. And Monica, my fiance, was really putting it together. And I finally realized how stressful it was. I came home one night, and I look out in the backyard, and here she is with a drink and a cigarette in her hand. She hadn't smoked in 4 years, and she's out in the backyard, you know, crying. You know, I go, I think there's a problem here. So I went out and we talked about it. And she said, you know, what are we going to do? You know, we get more and more people calling, saying, how come we haven't gotten our invitation to the wedding? And family members who we hadn't heard from in 15 years. And so I said, she said, I don't know what to do. I said, let's just stop, regroup, and do what we originally were going to do, just have immediate family and have a small wedding. And so that's what we did. But we still went on our honeymoon to Greece. You know, we took a, I cruised the Greek islands for about 9 days.
So you did get married, or you're going to get married later?
I'm going to get married later.
With the just immediate family and, and me, of course.
Yeah, of course you
will. Yeah, right.
Absolutely.
You know, because
I'm
available.
You're immediate family.
You know, I'll be there in case anybody tries to karate chop.
Okay,
yeah.
You got it.
You know, maybe I'll bring Bob Barker as my date.
Yeah, hey, he would love that.
That would be fun.
He would love it.
Now, your show, Walker, Texas Ranger, is on Saturdays at CBS. It's a huge hit, and it's a great show. Do you enjoy doing it?
Yeah, I do. You know what's amazing? You know, when I first started the show, it was like 90% male viewing audience. But now, demographically, I just found out that my largest viewing audience are kids 2 to 11, and number 2 are women, and number 3 are men. Now, so it's really made a big transition over the last 3 years. It's the hardest thing I've ever done. You know, when you do a movie, you'll spend 8-10 weeks, you know, doing an hour and a half movie. On a TV series, you're doing a one-hour movie every 7 days.
Right.
And I do 26 of these without a break, so that's 10 months without a break.
That's
so it's pretty tough.
And they're long hours. It's like 12-hour days, right?
Yeah, 12 to 15 hours.
15-hour days. That's a hard. Do you ever get hurt on the show? Because it's a lot of stunts and everything.
Yeah, actually, I did. I just did an episode where I grab a rattlesnake. You know, I'm supposed to grab this rattlesnake and pick it up and count the rattlers on it. So, I got hurt on this one here.
You know what? We have a clip.
Well, the first time I did it, I got him okay. And I picked him up and did it. And so now take two. Well, in take two, that rattlesnake was ready for me this time. And amazingly, you know, it takes 24 frames a second. Well, that snake turned and grabbed me and bit me in 3 of those 24 seconds.
Wow, so it's like,
frames.
It's like
that's how fast
a quarter
that
of a second or something.
About a quarter of a second.
And did it hurt a lot?
It was like a needle, like two little needles.
Did it have poison in him?
No, that's what thing. No, what happened? They devenomized, of course, the snake. But when he hit me, hit a vein, and of course the blood was flying all over the place.
Yuck!
And but I'm still shooting. So they you know patched me up and
little silly putty in there.
Yeah, exactly. It was like quick glue or something, whatever that stuff is. And then I had to go to the hospital and make sure that all the venom was out.
Yeah. What's this program that you have about kids? I want to mention that before we go.
Well, I have a program called Kick Drugs Out of America where I work with high-risk inner-city children. And right now we're in 18 schools in Dallas and Fort Worth, and we have about 2,000 kids in the program. And the whole purpose of our program, again, is working with these youngsters is to help steer them away from gang activity and drugs and get them directed in a positive way. And that's what's great about the martial arts. The martial arts is really a good way to help raise your self-esteem and instill the discipline and respect that a lot of time kids are lacking, and that's what the whole program is
about. And that's a great program, and I'm really I think that's great that you're spending your time doing that.
Well, it's you know something that's needed. We need more programs like this going
on. We sure do. Chuck Norris, ladies and gentlemen, Walker, Texas Ranger.